How do we get people to change their behavior? Let's say we want Tom to make healthier choices. One common way is to use the carrot and stick method. We could give Tom a carrot or reward every time he chooses the salad over the cake. And we could punish Tom with a stick every time he chooses the escalator over the stairs. This method of giving rewards and punishments work if humans behave rationally. We give rewards hoping that people will repeat good behaviors, and we give punishments hoping that people will stop bad behaviors. However, people don't always behave rationally. Even though they know that being healthy is good, they may get lazy or rationalize poor decisions. This is where nudging can become helpful for changing people's behavior. In 2008, behavioral economist Richard Thaler and legal scholar Cass Sunstein popularized the concept of nudging. This means that we can alter people's environments to capture their attention and gently push them to make certain decisions. Nudges don't take people's freedom. They provide suggestions for people to try without any force. For example, in Sweden, people coming in and out of a train station saw piano stairs, where with each step, a note would play. By adding some fun to the steps, people naturally became curious and were nudged to use the stairs instead of the escalator. As a result, people got extra steps in without realizing that they were making the healthier choice. When nudging, we can't promise that everyone will take the piano stairs. However, we can influence people's behavior without fear or coercion.